three former Supreme Court justices from actually across the sort of the board in terms of their politics, you know, including Lady Hale. We remember her from the proroguing of Parliament under Boris Johnson in 2019. And, of course, Lord Sumption, Jonathan Sumption, who was a very, very, very prominent anti-lockdown campaigner. They have joined more than 600 legal experts calling for the UK government to end weapon sales. They say this would avoid UK complicity in grave breaches of international law, including, they say, potential violations of the Genocide Convention. They say we need to do more to protect civilians and we need to do less in terms of helping Israel propagate their war against Hamas. Do you agree with them, Steve?
Well, firstly, it's not a war against Hamas. It's a genocide of the Palestinian people. But yes, I do agree with him.
Could you sit still while you're talking, by the way?
I think that even Margaret Thatcher back in the 1980s saw the genocidal nature of the Israeli state when they invaded Lebanon. There are a load of settler colonialists. They've got no right to be there. They live on stolen Palestinian land. And they're perpetrating genocide, the whole world.
They're perpetrating genocide. Yeah. Do you know what genocide means?
Yes, there's five definitions of genocide.
Any word that's got five definitions,
we can get five qualifications, and the international community, United Nations, the special rapporteur, has said that they fulfill three of them. There's credible evidence of three of them.
Destroying a people
in part or in full.
All right, there's no evidence that Israel is trying to destroy a people.
That's literally Hamas's constitution.
No.
From 1947, 1948, we've had stolen land. We've had people driven ethnically cleansed from their land.
We've got ongoing
settlements that continually steal more land. We've had Palestinians massacred in their tens of thousands, Palestinian children massacred in their tens of thousands.
You use the word massacre and you use the word genocide, Steve. You're not at a union meeting now. Right.
Well, obviously.
No, obviously. We're having a conversation.
We're having you speak with me.
But you weren't going to stop, my love. When you use the word genocide, it's genocide. It means the deliberate massacring en masse of a people.
I thought you might say that, Julia. Okay. So I've got some quotes here. We are
lovely.
We've got Netanyahu on record. We've got Herzog on record dehumanizing Palestinians. We've got war crimes perpetrated, collective punishment.
You're not quoting, you're just giving your views again. No, I am quoting.
I'm going to quote Yoav Galantz, the defense minister, saying that there would be a siege of Palestine, there'd be no water, that there would be no food, that there'd be no electricity. We had not only the government in this country condoning that, but with the leader of the opposition condoning that. So there's clearly an intent to genocide.
I have to say the Israeli Defense Forces are clearly very rubbish at it in terms
Israeli
of
Israeli occupation
oh,
forces.
Okay, if
the Israeli genocidal
can we,
forces.
Can we finish a sentence? Right. Israel is a very, very efficient fighting force, and yet they are so bad at their genocide, there are more people living...
Would you dare say that if 30,000 Jews have been killed? Would you dare say that? Would you dare say that if 30,000 Israelis have been killed? You would be the first one claiming genocide.
Don't point your finger and shout at me, my love. It's not going to work with me. It doesn't intimidate
me. Don't play the feminist card,
please.
I wasn't playing the feminist card. The woman who said she wanted Boris Johnson, you wouldn't wash Boris Johnson's arm. Don't play the feminist
card. Steve, I've known you a very long time. We're not at a shouty meeting now.
Let's get this straight.
When you use the word genocide, it is incorrect.
You would be screaming genocide, wouldn't you?
Here's the difference.
The difference is Palestinians are brown people. And you are...
Oh, you're brown, and I'm what?
You're a Zionist troll.
I'm a Zionist troll.
You're on the payroll, aren't you?
I'm on the payroll.
When
am I getting those checks? Seriously, the Israeli government, when am I getting my checks?
You're working for Rupert Murdoch.
So I'm a Zionist troll.
How?
I love the way you say that Zionist...
You're on the payroll.
You say the word Zionist, which I'm sure in your circles is one of the worst slurs you can call people. I don't think supporting the democratic state of the Jewish people of Israel is a slur. Why is it an apartheid state?
Well, because they have different laws for the Palestinians and the Israelis.
They do not.
If you're a Palestinian, you cannot drive down the same street as an Israeli. This is not my opinion. This is United Nations. Again, United Nations
nonsense.
Have verified this.
This is one of the most senior.
You know, you lie, Julia. You come on here and you lie and you lie.
I lie.
I'll tell you the consequences of your lies. The consequences of your lies.
My lies.
Is that
yes.
it enables genocide in the
enables
Middle
genocide.
East. The lies
Again,
about
beheaded
babies. The lies about mass rape. The lies about fetuses being cut out of pregnant women. This was all lies.
Right.
It's proven to be lies.
It's
and
not proven to be lies.
You are a perpetrator of
Steve
lies.
Steve Hedley,
so therefore,
I'm genuinely
you are a perpetrator of genocide.
Yes, you are.
You're a genocide enabler.
I haven't had that one, but I've been called so many things in the last
enabler.
6 months. I'm now a perpetrator of
you come
genocide
on here, a
as
paid
well.
Liar.
I'm a paid liar.
I'm upset.
Anyway. So should we have a conversation or just want to carry on just shouting insults?
Let's do that.
Maybe this is part of the problem with this argument, isn't it? Right. I dispute, based on fact, the use of the word genocide because we're
how many,
not...
How many
let me finish it, for the love
how many,
of God.
How many dead children do you want, Juliet?
That's...
How many
okay.
dead children can you stomach
okay.
before it's a genocide?
How many dead children,
how many dead children?
Jewish children can you stomach
none.
From Hamas?
Absolutely not,
exactly.
because I don't support
the reason,
Hamas. I do not justify
you?
Genocide, no.
Okay.
But you obviously
can
support
I,
the killing of Palestinian
get...
children. Go on, condemn it then. Condemn the killing of Palestinian children.
As my
children.
Regular audience
condemn
will
condemn the killing
you,
of Palestinian children.
If you stop
children.
Talking for a nanosecond, I have on every single day since the war, not since Hamas, perpetrated.
Condemn the
let
killing
me,
of Palestinian
let
children.
Let me go finish
condemn,
a sentence.
Condemn
thank
Israel.
God I'm not Mrs. Hedley. Good
condemn
grief.
Condemn Israel. Condemn Israel. Go on.
No, I don't condemn.
Condemn Israel.
Is,
condemn the killing of Palestinian children.
Stop shouting at
condemn
me.
Condemn it. You won't condemn it. You
if,
won't
if,
condemn
if you
Israel.
Stop talking
you won't
for
condemn
a
the
nanosecond,
on,
I will finish
it.
A sentence.
Condemn
Steve.
It.
It's like being treated. It's like being talking to myself.
Condemn it.
I have.
Condemn it. Condemn
shut
Israel.
Shut up.
Condemn Israel.
Steve.
Condemn Israel.
Steve. Shut up.
Condemn Israel.
Shut
Julia.
Up.
Won't you condemn
you're
the genocide, Julia?
You're a bullying man.
Won't you,
shut
won't
up.
You condemn the genocide, Julia?
I will if you shut
well,
up.
Go on in.
Then.
Then
shut
it.
Up.
Condemn Israel.
Stop talking.
Condemn Israel.
Close your mouth.
Condemn
and
Israel.
Let me...
Condemn Israel. Go on, condemn them.
Stop talking.
Condemn them.
Stop talking.
Condemn them.
Right, has he stopped? Right, I have on every single...
Go on,
stop
no,
talking
condemn Israel.
On every single
condemn
show
Israel.
Since civilians were dying in Gaza.
They weren't dying, they were being killed. They were being murdered.
That involved dying. That involved
dying.
As a result of Israeli strikes, I have always said that the death of any civilian, obviously children even more so than men and women, is a terrible tragedy and awful. No
go
civilian
on,
should
them,
die
man.
In war.
Condemn them.
What do you want? I'm not condemning
condemn Israel.
Israel.
Go on, condemn
no,
the genocidal
because they are perpetrating
policy.
A defensive war.
They're an occupied no, power. They don't have the right to self-defense. They're an occupied
you don't,
power.
They don't have the right to self-defense.
An occupied
okay.
people have
the
right
that.
To resistance.
People do have a right to resistance.
Go on, condemn Israel.
No,
Julia.
I don't condemn,
condemn
Israel.
Them. Go on.
I condemn the death. I condemn
genocide.
The unnecessary
condemn
deaths of civilians in
yeah.
war.
Condemn.
That's not the same thing.
Condemn the Israeli regime.
No, I don't condemn the Israeli regime.
The government. Go on.
They're not fascists
yes, they
in
are.
The government. I don't agree with
yes,
the Israeli
they are.
Government. This isn't a conversation. This is you just sparking things at
yeah,
me,
yeah, because
Steve.
You won't condemn
here's
genocide.
The
you won't condemn
what is,
the massacre
you say,
of children.
No, I'm going, it's not a genocide. I always condemn the deaths
so the
of
United
civilians.
United Nations say it's a genocide, but you disagree.
United Nations has a lot of questions to
disagree?
Answer about their policies
oh, really?
On this.
All right, so the United Nations. What about the
United
Pentagon?
United Nations
the
were
Pentagon
a bit quicker to condemn Israel
the,
than they were
are
to
the
condemn
Pentagon,
Hamas.
Hamas stooges as well, are they?
The United Nations
the
women's
Pentagon,
body
Hamas
didn't
stooges?
Even condemn them, the rape
what?
Of women by Hamas on
well,
October the 7th, which you don't think even happened because you believe conspiracy theories.
The sexual violence against Palestinian prisoners. Of course, you don't care about them because they're brown women and men. Well, why don't you bring it up? Why don't you bring it up?
I hate to tell you that an awful lot of Jews are also brown and we
really?
Care about them
most
as well.
Most of them are from Eastern
My,
Europe and New York.
They're not.
Yes, they are. Yes, they are.
Huge, again, another conspiracy.
Yeah.
I don't think
it's
that
true.
Most people in this country, including myself, could care whether someone is white, brown, or any
well,
other
well,
colour
how
in the world.
Come you never
they
raised
about...
sexual violence against Palestinian women and Palestinian men, then, Julia? How come you've
by
never
whom?
Done that?
By whom?
By the Israeli IDF. Here
it
we
went...
go.
Wherever the Israeli forces commit an atrocity, just as whenever
right.
the British
so, so
forces...
So how come you've never raised
I
it in your show?
I can't even finish a
how
one,
come you've never
one
raised
sentence.
It? How come you've never raised it once in your
because
show?
Because we already have processes for dealing
no,
with
because for
deeds
you,
by our
for
officers.
You, for you, an Israeli life is more important than a Palestinian
no,
life. An Israeli woman is more important than a Palestinian woman. That's it.
You're
part of a hegemonic culture enabled by Zionism. Enabled by Rupert Murdoch, who treat the Palestinians as less than people.
I don't think anyone's treating the Palestinians
the
as less than people.
You're
the
genocide.
I think the Hamas
Not
terror...
once have you condemned
Shut
Israel.
Up!
Not once.
Have you raised the subject of Palestinian women being raped? Are you like
Palestinian
this at home?
Men being sexually assaulted?
Do you ever have a normal conversation with people?
Having a normal conversation with you? That's probably impossible,
you've
isn't it,
You've come into the studio to have a conversation.
Well, Julia...
And you've just shat...
I've just occupied your studio, you know... Imagine I'm the Israeli Defense Forces. You've asked me to come here, now
I've
just occupied it, I've took it
I've
over.
I've asked you to come
imagine
here for a
Imagine how the
conversation.
Palestinians feel after 75
I've
years.
I've asked for a... You're not a Palestinian living in war-torn Gaza.
No, but tell you what, Julia, let's get this straight, right?
Oh, here we go.
If Anne Frank was here today, you would be trying to put her on a plane to Rwanda and I'd be trying to keep her in the country. That's the difference between me and you. You will side with anybody that's in power.
I think if she was sat in a room with you, she'd want to go on a plane to Rwanda.
Wow. Wow, what
I'm not lying. I think she'd say I've had enough.
Frank wants to go on a plane to Rwanda where another genocide is taking place.
Can we try?
Okay,
let's narrow this conversation down. Who isn't committing genocide? Anyone? Is there anyone not committing genocide? There's me, Rupert Murdoch, the Israelis, Rwanda. We're all. No, you said I was a perpetrator of genocide.
You're enabler of genocide.
You said a perpetrator.
Your lies are enabling genocide.
Mm-hmm. My
lies are enabling genocide.
You're still
you're
perpetrating.
You're a paid liar and slanderer.
You're still perpetrating the lie that women weren't raped and abused on October the 7th.
Of course, you don't believe that women were raped by Hamas fighters, do you? I believe.
Interesting smile on your face when you said that.
I believe that there was instances of sexual violence, and I think they've been documented. There's absolutely no evidence of systematic rape carrying out
there's
by Hamas fighters.
Despite all the evidence.
There's evidence of rape.
Despite all the evidence.
Not systematic rape.
It wasn't used as a tool of war. Hamas literally put out footage themselves.
Why is it you never raise the subject of Palestinian women and indeed men being sexually assaulted, being raped by the Israeli Defense Forces?
Is that in Palestine? It doesn't matter to you. I just asked you a question. In Palestine and in Israel. Such as that comes up as a news story, we will be discussing that on the show.
It's been documented for years. It's never come on your show. Because you're
Israeli
completely
forces
biased.
Haven't been in Gaza since 2005.
They've been in the West Bank continually.
We just talked about Gaza.
They've been in the West Bank continually. They've been arresting people from Gaza.
They've
been holding thousands of prisoners.
I do not defend crimes committed by any. But they don't matter to you.
Of course. You've never had one program about it.
Is there a chance that you'll shut up to listen to Benedict? Do you want to have a go? See if you can ask anything or say anything or just shell-shocked by this?
Which part? which part? What should we do?
I don't know.
Honestly, I think this is a real sign of unhappiness, unhealthiness in the conversation, is that on this issue, actually people are incapable of having a dignified conversation. It descends into accusations and slander very quickly.
I don't think
that helps anybody is the key thing. I don't think actually anybody, if they were able to watch this in Gaza, would be watching it and going, fantastic, I feel so much better. My case
has made a difference.
I don't think that actually
helps. But now, hold on a minute. Steve, you've managed to virtue signal, we'll put the clip out, and then your lot will go, oh, God, isn't he wonderful standing up? What have you done in any way this conversation to help put your case, to help put the case of the Palestinian people?
Julia, I've given the voiceless people a very, very limited voice, right? Because I'm not a Palestinian, but I grew up under British oppression. I was there when they massacred 14 people.
Was that a genocide as well?
14 people in my home. Don't trivialise
the massacre. You trivialised the word genocide.
Really, Julia. There you are. Your lies and your slander
and my genocide.
You're not trying to goad me, right? Because you don't.
No,
want to
I've got to go to a
point.
Break. Actually,
you don't want to address the point, Julia. Which is there's a genocide going on in Gaza, and you, a paid liar and
a slanderer, are giving that genocide cover
because you're helping to dehumanise the Palestinians.
Dehumanise them.
The lies about babies being ripped from their mothers' wombs. You repeated them all, as did the President of the United States.
And
dehumanize the Palestinians.
I'm going to have to leave it there.
Justify.
Do you have an off? Can I turn you off? You've got an off
button. No, you can't. No.
Oh, okay.
No.
Right, Steve's going to carry on shouting at me and abusing me and insulting me. We're going to go to a break. Coming up after. Coming up after the break. Again. You're the one who's making a mockery. You are totally, utterly making a mockery,
Julia.
We'll go to a break. We're talking about something else afterwards, unless Steve's still here shouting at me. This is talkTV. Good luck, everyone. Enjoy the quiet.